Hey YouTube, so it is time for some Chevy problems. As you can see, I put my key in and turn the car on. We have no illumination from the speedometer. The VFD has literally no illumination. In the dark, I checked to see if you could see the fine wires, and you can't. So this is telling me that there's no B plus supply. It very well may be that it's just a common fault with this, which is the VFD module has electrical contacts on the back that touch little, basically little pogo springs. They're kind of like flat copper springs, and they just touch it. But the problem is over time they get corroded and then they don't work anymore. So let's take this apart and see what we can find. In here, we're currently kind of halfway there, but watch this. Yep, definitely a contact problem. Luckily, this isn't so hard to do. I mean, I don't even have to take the whole dashboard apart or anything. Nothing had to drop. So, with that, let's turn the car off. Let me see if it turns back on. Nope, nothing. It won't even turn back on. So we just got to take this piece out very carefully, because it is currently engaged. Actually, you know what? We'll want to give it a little bit of slack. That way it can just flip right down. There we go. So we don't need to take it all out. So basically, the contacts are like right under here. If I turn the car back on and then tap it, we can get it to light up again. So let's go ahead, take these four bolts out, remove the module, and I'll show you what contacts we're talking about here. Here we go. So I have the VFD module removed. If we flip it over, here's the contacts we're talking about. This right here and right here. Now this car has already been repaired at one point, but as I discovered, if you notice, the solder pads lift up very easily because I tried to reflow the solder to get rid of these little divots. As I've learned, don't bother. Now the solder pad that lifted wasn't actually connected anyway, so that was actually okay. I'm assuming this one right here, because it's all beefy, is probably the B plus supply. Let me see, where is it going? It could be the ground. But anyway, here's the actual springs. They're right here. These are what the springs actually look like. And basically, this is what steps up the voltage right here to drive the B+. Now, we know that works because tapping the module makes it work, which I know is just, it needs cleaning. So, I have here some rubbing alcohol and paper towel. Let's go ahead and clean everything and put the module back in and see if it works with no problems. Okay, so I have used rubbing alcohol. I also got some deoxit and ran it on the contacts. I didn't put it on the spring because the spring is gonna, you know, it's gonna absorb the deoxit once the actual contacts touch the spring. However, when I turn it on, if the VFD shows corrupted odometer characters, that's actually has nothing to do with the contacts. That has to do with the logic on the board itself. I believe it's like a cracked solder joint. However, let's test it. And it's actually working. It's actually showing the correct reading. And I don't know if it's just me, it looks much, much brighter. So, looks like we are all fixed. Take that back. It just died again already. And if I push in one or on the VFD itself, and that's not doing it, of course. I have no idea what's going on. It fades in and fades out. That didn't actually fix it at all. So, unfortunately, I have no idea what's still going on. Maybe there is just more cracked solder joint somewhere, but it's got those sealant on it. You can't exactly do much with it, unfortunately, because you can't actually get to the solder. So this whole module might just need to be replaced. That's a shame. Since cleaning wasn't working, we're going to go ahead and reflow the solder for all these pads to get rid of those little divots in them and see if maybe that'll work. Alright, well, I did what I could, including this side. This side ended up being a little bit more messy, but we're going to use some rubbing alcohol once again just to clean up the pads, get off the rosin flux, and hopefully this works. After countless failed attempts to try to get this thing to work, I decided to take the whole cluster into the car. I didn't want to have to do this, but I have a feeling I might. You see, this is the board that generates the high voltage. This is what's actually providing the B plus to the VFD. If tapping it makes it work, and I've inspected the VFD module in and out, and the continuity is good between these pins, then the problem might be with the module here. So let's desolder it and check for cracked solder joints. Well, first, let's check the bottom of this first. Because it's a daughter board, we can check the pins here, on this side at least. And, well, in typical Samsung Galaxy Note fashion, it doesn't work very well. Well, not certain if you see that, but it does look like there could be potentially some cold solder joints on all of the pins. Now, I'm just looking through the screen on my phone, so I'm not exactly certain if that is what I'm seeing. But let's desolder it and check the actual board itself too, since obviously this may be the potential point of failure. I don't know if you can see what I can see, but there's definitely some cracked solder joint on those pins. Some a little bit more noticeable than others. I'm trying to get a good shot, but we all know the Samsung Galaxy Note 4 doesn't know how to focus correctly. But yeah, there's some problems with those pins. They don't look that good. So, let's resolder this entire board, actually. Yeah, I'm just going to redo the entire board. I'm just going to reflow the whole thing. Why not? There's no reason to half-ass it. So, let's resolder it, put it back in the board here, the actual cluster board, and then put it back in the car and see if we can get it to come on first try. Okay, quick preliminary test. I just have two bolts holding the VFD on. Two bolts holding down where the connectors are. I haven't even put the backing on it yet, but let's see. Hey, hey! Oh, and look at that, it's showing the right the odometer reading too. Usually it just shows all eights down there. Interesting. Well, it's working. Let me test the dimmer. Now I do need to shove some dioxide in my dimmer switch, unfortunately, so that's why that's flickering. That's normal, if I just do this real quick. Alright. Looks like everything is working as it should be. Sweet! I can put everything back together now.